right.
When praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Whoa, boy.
This is Praise and Worship Hour. It's
Praise and Worship Hour right here on Spreaker Radio LPJ. It's a beautiful night. It's a beautiful night. 20 minutes after 9, and we are praising the Lord up in here.
Yes, we are.
That's what we're doing. Love, peace, and joy. I tell you, that's what you get when you listen to
Spreaker Radio.
With Inspiration After Dark with Mr. and Mrs. Sweet Thing. We praise the Lord up in here. We thank him for what he's done for
us. And that's what we're supposed to do.
And that's what we do. I hope you do the same thing, because that's what it's all about here on Spreaker Radio, here with Inspiration After Dark.
You know, and with so much going on, God is good all the time. He keeps us each and every day. And you know what? We have to. We need to lift up the name of Jesus. Because you know what? What he done for me, for you, and for everybody else, he is always worthy to be praised.
We don't understand what's going on right now. We don't understand why God is allowing things to happen the way it's happening.
But he's going to get the glory.
But he's going to get the glory. And that day that we sit around the table and sup with him, he'll explain it all to us. He'll tell us all. Everything that we want to know, why this happened and why that happened. We'll have time for God to talk with us.
That's right. So no matter what's going on, no matter what you're dealing with, you just continue to follow the Master, which is our Heavenly Father, and keep it locked in on Inspirations After Dark, and we have our daily bread.
Hello, thanks for joining us for Our Daily Bread. Your host is Les Lamborn.
Are you willing to follow Christ? Jennifer Benson Schult has written today's meditation titled Following the Master. At a dog show near my home, I watched a Cardigan Welsh Corgi named Trevor perform. At his master's command, he ran several yards away and immediately returned. He jumped fences, and he identified objects using his sense of smell. After finishing each exercise, he sat down at his master's feet, waiting for more instructions. Trevor's careful attention to his master's instructions reminded me of the devotion God desires from his people as they followed him through the wilderness. God led in a unique way. His presence appeared as a cloud. If the cloud ascended, he wanted his people to move to another area. If the cloud descended, they were to stay put. At the command of the Lord, they remained encamped, and at the command of the Lord, they journeyed. The Israelites followed this practice day or night, regardless of how long they had to remain in one place. God wasn't simply testing the Israelites. He was leading them to the promised land. He wanted to take them to a better place. And so it is with us when God asks us to follow him. He wants to lead us to a place of closer fellowship with himself. His word assures us that he is loving and faithful in leading those who humbly follow him. Numbers chapter 9, verses 15 through 18 and verses 22 and 23 describe how the Lord led Israel in the wilderness. And I'll read from Numbers chapter 9, verses 15 through 18, and verses 22 and 23. Now, on the day that the tabernacle was raised up, the cloud covered the tabernacle, the tent of the testimony. From evening until morning, it was above the tabernacle, like the appearance of fire. So it was always. The cloud covered it by day, and the appearance of fire by night. Whenever the cloud was taken up from above the tabernacle, after that the children of Israel would journey. And in the place where the cloud settled, there the children of Israel would pitch their tents. At the command of the Lord, the children of Israel would journey, and at the command of the Lord they would camp. As long as the cloud stayed above the tabernacle, they remained encamped. Now verses 22 through 23. Whether it was 2 days, a month, or a year that the cloud remained above the tabernacle, the children of Israel would remain encamped and not journey. But when it was taken up, they would journey. At the command of the Lord, they remained encamped, and at the command of the Lord, they journeyed. They kept the charge of the Lord, at the command of the Lord, by the hand of Moses. Father, we ask that you would forgive us for not being obedient followers. Help us from this day forward to follow obediently the path that Christ asks us to walk. And may we follow closely our Savior and leader, the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you. Amen.
Church back in the woods, where those mothers and fathers would get up and start singing an old hymn, and everybody would just fall in and talk about having church. But folks don't sing those old hymns no more like they used to. We decided to put together a little melody of hymns and just see, can we recapture the feeling of the old church? Oh, I can see those mothers just swaying from one side to another. Seem like the church would just go to rocking from one side to another. Look like everybody was just gonna catch wings and just go on up to glory anyhow. Oh, what a time, what a time. I want to ask you, do you remember any of these? If you do, why don't you sing along with us? Here's the first one right here, you may remember.
Oh, amazing grace,
Lord,
how sweet the sound
that saved the rest. You know what?
I once was
lost, but now that's not all. I was blind and seeing, but thank God. Wait a minute, y'all. There's another one. Somebody may remember this. Father,
I stretch.
If you remember that, why don't you sing it with us?
My hands
to thee. No other help.
I know.
Oh, Lord. The hymn writer said,
If thou thyself
away from me. I often have to wonder, church, where shall I? But there's one girl that really touched my heart. It become my favorite.
Was Jesus
that all